Hey, Robin and Larry, good morning. Throughout this strike, teachers we spoke with have said they are anxious to get back to the classroom where they belong. Student athletes were eager to get back to school so they could get back on the field. And parents are especially relieved that the strike is finally over.
Every day that they're out, you got to try to scramble to see where your child is going to go, especially if they're underage children that can't look after themselves. You know, and all that costs money.
What are they doing with their parents? What's going to motivate the kids to go back to school? They've been out for 12 days.
I just felt it was too long for the kids to be out. They're out of whack with sleep and crazy, but I'm happy they're back.
It was a long 2 weeks for CPS families, but the strike finally came to an end after a rally outside City Hall Thursday morning. The CTU wanted pay for all 11 missed school days due to the strike. At first, Mayor Lightfoot said there's no way that would happen, but after a two-hour meeting, CTU and CPS agreed to make up 5 days. Mayor Lightfoot said it was in the interest of getting students back in the classroom. Overall, the CTU got most of what they asked for. The tentative agreement has been touted by both sides as a historic measure to improve Chicago public schools. It includes a 16% pay raise, a nurse and social worker in every school every day, and $35 million to reduce class sizes. But the deal is not done just yet. The full union still needs to vote on the contract before it's finalized. Now, this morning here at Yates Elementary School, the union will meet with teachers as they walk back into the classroom together. That's at around 7:45, so we'll bring you the latest at 8 o'clock.